We've been rather talking in this discussion as if all organized thinking is done in language, but of course that in fact isn't so, is it? I mean, one can take all kinds of examples. In music is one that appeals to me very much. If you get a composer like Stravinsky composing a fantastically complicated and original and indeed revolutionary score like that of The Rite of Spring for an enormous orchestra, then he's cerebrating at an original and complicated and very sophisticated level, and he's probably cerebrating in as elaborate a way as anybody else is who's doing anything. And what's more, he's creating a structure which is publicly articulated and so on, and yet words don't come into this process at any point, as far as one can gather. Does that fact and other facts like it pose any threat to your theories?
Well, not really. I mean, in fact, quite the contrary. My assumption is that the mind is not a uniform system, that it's a highly